Hello everyone, Shadefire here, and today I'm taking a first impressions look at yet another early access open world survival sandbox multiplayer game. However, this one has a bit of a questionable pedigree. This is Romero's Aftermath, which, you know, kind of a silly name. They're just trying to invoke a bit of the old classic zombies with Romero. But this is actually made by the same developers who made a little game called The WarZ. Yes, that WarZ, or Infestation Survivor Stories, if you're going with the later name. But to me, it will always be known as WarZ. And obviously, WarZ had a lot of shit around it, including a bunch of shitty developers who said shitty things all the time, including a certain Sergey Grigorovich. But this is available freely to people who played the WarZ and did not have a banned account, which is probably only a fraction of the people who played the WarZ, so once the hacks became pretty widely available. And I figured I'd give this a go. Now, I'm going to point out right off the bat, I played WarZ, I enjoyed it at points. There were some times where I, in fact, did have fun in WarZ. I know that may shock you, because everyone wants to be on the hate train, which I'm totally okay with. They deserve a lot of the shit that people threw their way because they were shitty developers who did shitty things. But on a base level, the game was at times enjoyable, and at the time, there wasn't a lot of these survival sandbox games out there. I'm curious to see if this is any better than WarZ was at the end of its life cycle. Well, I say end of its life cycle. You can still play WarZ. It still exists. They will still take your money. But this is supposed to be them learning from what they did. You know, they're not going to sell guns and stuff. They're only going to sell skins and characters and stuff in the money shop instead of just straight up selling you guns and bullets and stuff now, as they did later on in WarZ cycle. It has building and crafting and vehicles and all that. Basically everything they added to the corpse of WarZ, known as Infestation. You can see right off the bat, they know their player base, as there are in fact a lot of Brazilians that played the WarZ. And they'd kind of swarm on you. Apparently that's the only thing you can buy right now. Alright, let's quit fucking about and actually get in the fucking game. You can see not a lot of servers yet. They're apparently adding another game mode soon. This has only been out for like a week or two, I believe. So let's just join up the most populous... The most populous one. Novice Server 03. And let's see what we see. Alright. Right off the bat, we are in a desert. And there is a semi-transparent building up there. So, immediately, very different map from the default Colorado map it used to have. Though they did add a California map to the WarZ. Can we... third person? I'm just going to fuck around with the keys as we walk here towards... Okay, there's first person, third person on C. Now, obviously, there are reasons to not like that and to like that. We can actually punch, so we're not completely helpless until we find a weapon. Now, I have everything set to high, so I don't know why everything is not loading in properly. Other than, you know, that seems kind of typical for these kind of games. I'm going to guess that this is a blueprint for a player object. Okay, yeah, it looks like you gotta contribute all these materials. So they didn't really have any player-built stuff in the WarZ until they added the Stronghold servers, and by then nobody was playing it anymore, so that was all kind of wasted. It looks like someone has just covered the area in these blueprint things. Oh, we actually do start with a weapon. Just bring up the inventory here. We got a carrot, a campfire, some purification tablets, some stew. We got armor plating. Are we just wearing this under our shirt or something? And a blade with 6 out of 6 durability, I guess? That's it. It's kind of low, but maybe it takes a lot to break something. Let's find a... okay, that's kind of a wimpy poke. Still got the zoom, which is nice. I like being able to kind of see things. So I guess I should mention a couple things I actually did like about the WarZ. First of all, the blue outlines on all the loot. I like being able to walk into a building and see, like, oh man, there's actually some stuff in here because you can see it from a distance, even in the dark. Unlike something like DayZ, where you have to, like, you know, actually squint at everything and be like, is that a can, or... So I'm gonna guess that these are player-built structures, and the reason they're floating is because what was under them got destroyed or something? Or because this is shittily made. I don't know. That was a town over there. That seems way more exciting. So I guess we're gonna want to find a zombie and see if you still have to aim above their head to actually hit them in the head. Because in the WarZ, the melee animation was not determined by where the crosshair was. I just noticed there is no crosshair. But rather, you have to actually make sure the animation connects with their head, which is, I don't know, maybe neat? Instead of just having it arbitrarily hit where the crosshair is, but at the same time, it was a pain in the ass, because why have a crosshair? Now, I'm gonna guess that these things here are... like, player land plots? Like, you can only build around one of these you put down? Okay, I'm gonna guess the reason these are floating is because they're on hills, and the hills are not collided very well for that. Either that, or they built stuff under it and then built on top of that and then removed what was under it. Somebody in global recruiting. Also, I noticed we start with a fairly large-looking backpack, though we don't actually seem to have a slot for that, so maybe you just always have a big backpack. You didn't really have a backpack slot in WarZ, you just kind of replaced yours with whatever one you picked up if it was bigger. Alright, let's see what's in this jaggy sit. Can I get rid of these jaggies? I didn't see an aliasing option. See if I... Well, that's a little better, but now everything looks kind of blurry. I also noticed when I opened this up, there is a customize area. So you can change your face and everything, and not everyone look exactly the same. Some hair options. Alright, here's the actual shop stuff, I guess. Which, it looks like they're doing the nether thing of having it so you can actually buy the stuff with in-game money. It just costs a ridiculous amount. And if this is anything like the other game, you, it looks like you start with a hat. If this is anything like the other game, well, obviously I gotta get the sombrero, then, you get money mostly from zombies. You get zombie bucks from stabbing them. Yeah, it looks like they have a lot of customizables, even if they all are, you know, for actual money. But, hey, better that than being able to buy guns and stuff. Alright. I probably should have looked at what the voice chat button was in case we actually run into someone. Okay, prone is still the same button. I think it's the SSAO that's making it really blurry like this. Which is not how occlusion is supposed to work. Also, man, look at those sweet grass sprites. Okay, turn the SSAO off. Everything still kind of looks blurry. I think that just might be the game. Oh, zombie. Okay, these are the same zombie sound effects. Looks like they still get confused when you hit them in the head, which is good. Because in the first... Oh, God. And they can still hit you from far away. In the first game, in WarZ, you could basically stunlock any zombie with a melee weapon. As long as there were only one of them. I just want to search a house. The only reason I play these games is to fill my pockets with shit. Is that a sleeper zombie? Or is that somebody else's dead zombie? Nope, that was a sleeper. So it looks like all the stuff they had in WarZ is still here. They probably have the flanker zombies still too, who would take the long way around to get behind you. Which is pretty silly when they do it, and they're the only zombie coming after you, because they're just like, what are you doing? So So these are the same sound effects. I don't remember if these are the same zombie models. I don't know how much of this is just recycled stuff. Some salsa chips, some bandages. Okay, so they have a yellow outline now instead of a blue one. The fuck is that sound? Oh, you know, I think that's one of those ambient zombies banging on walls thing. Alright, so it looks like there's actually loot in cars, which is new. Rusted beat stick. Some more armor. Is that the same kind of armor? Alright, looks like we just have double armor now. I don't know, is the beat stick a great for beating off zombies? Come here, let me beat you off, zombie. You know, when are we going to have one of these survival zombie games with, like, condemned sort of melee, where you can just rip stuff off of walls and your weapons constantly break? Oh, look. AIDS cure. And some antibiotics, which, if they're anything like the other antibiotics, are just a healing item. Can of beans. Smoke grenade. Notched blade. Flame on torch. Flame on. Tylenex. What is all this crap I'm picking up? Okay, another knife. It has a cool rubber grip. Oh, it actually tells you damage numbers now. That's astounding. Except this one doesn't, so never mind. Okay, so they still have zombie infection. Healing item, that zombie saw me. 25 health. Cure a blood infection. And torch. Okay, those are definitely gunshots. Someone is blasting something. I think. Because, WarZ also had some, like, ambient zombies hitting stuff sounds. And I would not be surprised if that's actually what that was. Because otherwise, that's a lot of gunshots. Oh, loot backpack. Oh, this is somebody's backpack. I'll take the binoculars. Put these in there. Firewood. Somebody definitely got shot there. Is that a zombie coming after me, or just making coming after me noises? Box of lard, purification tablets. I wonder if we'll find a police station or something, because those always had guns in them. Oh yeah, I lost my train of thought when I was talking about the stuff I actually liked about WarZ. So the blue outlines on stuff. When you kill a player, the loot, the pinata loot that comes out of them just flies out everywhere, a big pile of stuff. The safe zones, there were safe zones you could go back to where no one could kill you, but you could drop off your stuff into your global inventory. Which, you know, on the one hand, that kind of encourages people to poop sock and just have shit ton of guns so they never have to look for more guns. But for someone like me who really just likes picking up all that crap and then carrying it there, it's a tasty window cleaner. It gave me something to do. I wonder if you can use that, like in DayZ, to poison people and making them eat bleach. Oh, let's pick up item. Oh, you know what? I think that was one of the loot containers that give you a random thing. You used to be able to get rare guns out of them. Which gave us a hefty crowbar, which is probably a better weapon. You have fun with that zombie. Oh, so it sounds like, according to the... I don't know what that exclamation mark is. It sounds like, from the chat there, there is a big group of people hiding here. And they're just capping everybody. Which, you know, I have been a member of a big group like that and went around killing everybody, so, you know, can't really blame them too much. But that kind of blows for me. Because I'm guessing they're hanging on to whatever is good around here. Never mind those random checker boxes popping up. I guess that there's nothing good in this liquor store. There's a surprising amount of melee weapons lying around. Which is good, because you kind of need them if you want to deal with zombies. I'm guessing it's mostly because of the durability, though. Ow, I think I got shot. Or hit by a zombie, I can't tell. I took very little damage there. Yeah, it looks like I'm not getting money from killing them, and they're not dropping money. That's probably better than a machete, or than a... just have a pocket full. Oh. No. Does 7 less damage. Bar of soap. Oh, there's smoke grenade. Wow, you can really carry a lot of shit. 20 damage. Wow, that's even worse. How's our food and water doing? Looks like they're doing alright. Did I get shot? I didn't hear a gunshot or anything, I just kind of took damage. Not very much. Oh, there's a vehicle. Police car bouncing around. That's some good sinking. It's like Arma 2 all over again. There's no other way out of this house. I'm gonna guess that they're gonna get out and start shooting. Oh, Jesus Christ. The zombies fuck up your car real good. Don't worry, I'm gonna help. Oh, why did that... why did that get their attention? Oh, that's an armed guy. Ow. He's gonna hit me, isn't he? It's okay. Melee weapons do not work great in games like this anymore, because you can usually outrun somebody for 20 minutes. Is that a gunshot? Or a weird particle effect? Soap. That's not a real building. Alright. Oh, a battery in the garbage. It seems like loot spawns in a lot more places than it used to. You know, I wonder if we can steal that guy's car. If I can even remember where that happened. Ugh. Okay, where was I? That's the same fucking guy. He's still chasing me. Well, he's not still chasing me. I think he just saw me again. He's like, oh, there he is. Bash his fucking head in. I didn't think there was more than one of them. Alright, so I've lived another life since the last death and wandered around a bit. And now I found myself in a military base, which seems to be marked on the map by these various gun icons. I guess those are any sort of military spawns. And found myself this gun and some ammo for it. So, hopefully I won't get gunned down as easily this time. So I guess I got lucky finding this because it came out of one of those random item boxes. The ones that used to always give you Desert Eagles. Not doing too hot though, I'm getting beaten up by zombies. Also discovered that when you respawn you do not have all that stuff I started with. That's like a very one-time thing for your first spawn. Which always seems silly because you're obviously going to lose that stuff because you don't really know what you're doing yet. But I've noticed that backpacks don't seem to be super hard to get. Which is nice, because the starting backpack is pretty small. Why is there a barn in this military base? So the zombie mechanics also seem to be pretty much the same. Also, I remember some of these models now, like that guy. Cash still seems to be very rare to drop, and you're only getting, like, less than 100 per drop, and some of those things cost like 400,000. Because they still really want you to spend money on that kind of stuff. It also seems like a lot of the stuff you find is just crafting components. You know, like stuff like this you can break into, and then it will turn into stuff like metal, chemicals, adhesives, all that stuff, which is used for the crafting here. You can see there's a bunch of weapons you can craft, including the one I picked up, this Manslayer. These are all kind of, you know, like cobbled together guns, which is kind of a neat aesthetic. Some silencers, grenades, even traps like this that people can step on. There's two of these. It looks like all of these are locked, though, so I'm assuming you need to find blueprints like you did in late WarZ. You know, you've got your, you can put down a camping sack to spawn on, you can build your makeshift shelter. Kind of all the stuff that's becoming more and more common now in these kind of games. That's some broccoli. I don't think it's called a head of broccoli. Bottle of acid. Can I throw that at somebody? I mean, I know this is in the Middle East, but... No, chemicals. Makes sense. I'm not sure if that really serves a purpose, though, that whole breaking down stuff. What the fuck? Did you see my food go all the way up there and then all the way back down? What the heck? Oh, it's a banana. I was like, is that a... I don't know. My food stuff seems to be pretty fucked up. Oh, look. Some steel armor. Okay, here's one another item box. Got a huge pouched pack, so that's probably just a really big backpack. Yeah, look at all those slots. Purification tablets are useful. You know, you can purify dirty water like this. Just right click, purify. Oh, shit. I hit drink, I meant to hit fucking... I think I have some sort of condition now. Which you can see next to my health and stuff, the little box looking icon. All of the chat still seems to be the same. Why did you kill me? You know, looking for friendlies. Friendlies in Cherno. Is that better? No, it's the same. I don't really know what I'm looking for here. It still astounds me how angry people get when someone kills them in these games. Like, at this point, I feel like that's just the social norm to expect. I don't think I've ever played a survival game where a big chunk of the player base wasn't just killing everyone they see. And that's not even an argument I want to get into, because there's some dumb shit on both sides of that argument. In a survival situation, you'd kill anyone you see because they might have stuff you need. But at the same time, I think the real reason it comes down to is there's not really a lot of penalty for killing someone because, you know, obviously they're going to respawn. It's not like you're a murderer. You just inconvenience someone by taking away their time that they use to find the shit that you killed before. That's really all it is. You're a time thief, if anything. I thought that was a person for a second. I definitely remember this store employee zombie model. I'm not really sure what I'm looking for, as I mentioned. I'm just kind of wandering around, seeing if there's any more crates. Anyone to shoot? Maybe a vehicle? Who knows? Looks like there's nothing on the edges of the base. I don't know if those work on zombies. I mean, it looks like it gets their attention. I'm actually surprised there's no one around here. The zombie combat mechanics are still just as awkward looking. You kind of poke them in the head a couple times. But yeah, so far this is seeming basically like a continuation of the WarZ more than anything. A lot of it's just reused shit that they kept and, you know, they added in some base building. But, I think the shooting probably still feels the same then too, which was one of the better parts. It does not feel awkward to try to murder someone in this like it does in, like, DayZ. There's a lot of backpacks in here. Some Drano. So yeah, it still has the good part of WarZ, as well as some new, you know, silliness. Who knows if that's actually a good thing or not. I was really hoping I could just fire that off. Why does it have stones in it? Alright, that did not get any of their attention. Let's find out how good this gun is. Alright, it is set to auto. I don't know how to switch it to not auto. Zero? No. Oh. I keep looking at that number at the bottom and thinking that's like my reserve ammo, but no, that is just the magazine capacity. Oh no. Got myself a little bit of a horde after me. So there's the map size. It's about the same size as Colorado. Still has just as much of the map that's not actually usable because it's mountains and shit. But yeah, that's Romero's Aftermath. If you have a WarZ account, you can actually just sign up for this and get it for free, not just as a demo, but as the full game. So that's kind of alright. If you happen to be somebody who has not been banned from WarZ, who, you know, accidentally spent money on it or something. But yeah, this seems the same. I wouldn't say it's worse, but I'm not really sure if it's better. I'll have to, you know, play a bit more of this with some other goons or something. But yeah, So I've been Shadefire. This is Romero's Aftermath. You can also buy into this for $15 if you really want to. But otherwise, yeah. I'll see. See how this is any fun or anything. And who knows? Maybe I'll do another video on base construction or something if I put some more time into this. But you all have a good day. Until then.